DJ Bix, Carrie B, I had the real honour that I'll cherish for my entire career of sitting next to you 17 years ago, the first time you were on television on Rove Live, a show that meant a lot to us. And I have this weird thing now where 17 years later, I'm here with you for your last show of another show that means a lot to both of us. Back then, you were a nervous girl from Adelaide slash Perth. I never worked out where. and now you have turned into this amazing professional and one of the best human beings in the biz. And that's been said a lot tonight. You have never, ever phoned an episode in when you had plenty of excuses to phone one in. The things you were juggling, the charity, family, radio, you never phoned one in. I'm just amazed. You care about the show, you care about the audience, you care about the news. You know, I always said if Carrie Bickmore couldn't find Coney in 2012, nobody could.
God, remember that. Yeah. We did a whole hour-long special on him.
Yeah.
What a disaster.
And you never found him. But anyway...
And then he peed behind a bush or something.
Not Coney.
But we have the most engaged audience in television. That's no secret, and I think that comes from you. You radiate generosity and empathy and warmth, and that just bounces back to us from our amazing audience. That you are the captain. It all starts with you. I cannot wait to see what you do next. Both.
Maybe we need our next show together.
Well, I think. Yeah. Hello, Ramsey Street. Anyone?
It's nice of you to plot your next show when I'm the one that's staying. Yeah, that's great.
But not only professionally, but personally. I know you're seething about not missing out on a current affair. But but also personally, spending time with the family and plotting your next move. Take your time, and I can't wait. And the audience will be here when you decide what you're going to do next, because you are Carrie F. and Bickmore.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. I mean, how do you follow everything that everyone said? It's been 8 years that we've been sitting next to each other, but actually it's been 11 since we started working together. It was the 10th anniversary of September 11 when I first sat there and you did that incredible package. And the thing about it I remember from that night was that I shouldn't be here. That was my first thought, is I don't belong here. And I felt instantly like I did, because I was sitting next to you. And then when Charlie left and there was all this question about whether I would join, I still remember being at the cricket and sitting there. You were at the cricket for some reason. I mean, that's a miracle.
Harry loves her cricket.
I remember you turned to me and you said, I really want you to do this, but you need to want to do it. It needs to be someone who's going to hang around, and here you are leaving me. So that's great. But I'm actually astonished you're the last of the original crew. I mean, I really thought it would be Ruby Rose, but apparently I was wrong with her. There's so much that everybody knows about how great you are. The stuff they see on camera, the stuff they don't see, or they don't realise they're seeing on camera, the fact that you can play in any key, which is so rare, very few people can do that. But I want to just talk really briefly about the stuff that they can't see, which is in the meetings, when your ability to look at a rundown and see the problem with it, that everyone who's been looking at it all day has not seen, and just go, no, that needs to move there, and that needs to move there, and that needs to go there, and now the show is 20 times better. And no one else can do that. And you're not, sometimes they ignore you because that's just the way it works.
That's what happens when you rock up late to the meeting.
Well, that's probably true.
But
you're just always right with those things. One of my favourite moments on the show that best encapsulated that was when the auto cue just went down. We were sitting on the stairs.
We lost everything.
We had nothing to play.
No,
Pete and I are sitting here going, well, I don't know, Pete, do you want to do some stand-up from... 2010.
No.
We had no idea to get through this.
It's not my problem.
This was all your idea in an instant.
To show you.
And you did this.
I'm going to read the news, and these guys are going to act out the news, because that's what we can do. Right, let's start with some sporting news. And Michael Jordan has once again topped Forbes magazine's list of the top earning retired athletes, raking in $110 million last year, thanks to booming sales of Nike and Jordan. Beckham has come in at number two, earning $65 million. Greg Norman is the top earning Aussie with $15 million, while China's Li Na is the highest placed woman. She's a tennis player. Oh, $14 million. Well done. Amazing. Michael Jordan to Michael Jackson. You got any moves? Because Michael... That there is news to delivered differently. Yeah, that is what that is.
It's also my career low light, but it was incredible. That you, just to think of that on the cuff, yeah. You make this show work.
Work
the way
is,
it is
not hard being here with you two. We move in sync in a way I don't think we often realise. And coming to work every day, I forget that I'm coming to a job because I'm just coming to hang out with you guys. Mm. I'm going to miss you stacks, but I know I'll see you outside of work. So it's not goodbye, just goodbye for now from this desk. So thank you. And thank you so much for all your support over my foundation over the years. You've been absolute champions of everything I've tried to do. And if you've just joined us now and you missed the beginning of the show, if it wasn't for this show, I wouldn't have my Beanie Foundation because I launched that at the Logies, which wouldn't have happened if it wasn't for this show. And I thought on the way out, let's try and raise one last bit of money for brain cancer research connected to this show. Yes, my foundation will go on. But tonight we are launching a limited edition range of caps. They're on sale now at carriesbeaniesofbraincancer.com. They are for tonight only, so get online, get quick. $20 million we've raised thanks to your incredible support over the years. So thank you to each and every one of you for everything you've done for my foundation so far.